God has no right to wash away the sins committed by us. The Buddha cannot do that. The God cannot do that. The person who has committed the mistake can do that. Please remember this. If we have committed certain bad, wicked, cruel thing, by praying to God, by praying to Buddha, you never get the chance to get rid of the bad effects. Because they cannot do that. But you can. The Buddha has pointed out how to do that. Without depending on God, without depending on Buddha or Bodhisattvas, how you can do that? Yassa papam katam kammam kusalena pithiyati. Direct sayings of the Buddha. If you have committed certain bad deeds, or bad karma, by realizing that it is wrong, stop. Not to repeat, then stop. From that day onward, try to cultivate more and more good karma. Then you will be able to overcome the bad effects of the bad deed that you have committed earlier by cultivating more and more and more good karma. Kusala karma. There are two words. The Buddhists have mixed up the meaning of these two words. I think non-Buddhists cannot understand that. But the Buddhists always use these punya karma and kusala karma. Punya karma in English only one word. Meritorious deeds. There is no another word. Punya karma means we do lot of good deeds by helping others, supporting others, and release their sufferings and poverty and sicknesses and all the other problems. All these are punya karma. You offer, donate so many things for the well-being of others. But by expecting something in return. You offer something to others by expecting something in return. That is called punya karma. By offering something, you aim, you aspire to be born in a rich family for you to enjoy your life. That is punya karma. By doing some meritorious deeds, you want to go to heaven and enjoy your life. That is punya karma. Because you expect some reward in return. Yes, you gain. You gain what you wanted. But after spending, one day you will go bankrupt. That good karma, that punya karma cannot support you forever. There is a limited period for that. This is the nature of punya karma. But kusala karma is different. It is mentioned like this. Adoso kusala moolam. Amoho kusala moolam. Adoso kusala moolam. How we can create kusala, kusala karma, highest good karma. When we do some good deeds to reduce our craving, to reduce our selfishness, it is kusala karma. When we do certain good deeds to reduce your anger, jealousy, grudge and ill will and wickedness and cruelty, it is kusala karma. When you do certain good deeds, reduce our ignorance, misconception, imagination, misunderstanding, it is kusala karma. Because you did not accept anything in return by doing that. But you develop your understanding, your mind, maintain some sort of development and purity in your mind, then what will happen? In the next birth, those non-Buddhists cannot accept that, it doesn't matter. After death, in the next existence, more understanding, more good qualities, more kindness, more knowledge, more wisdom gain. Because of this. That is how life after life we develop up to the final goal, final salvation. Not by praying to God, not by praying to Buddha, not by praying to Bodhisattvas or any supernatural living being, but by cultivating, developing, purifying our mind. Again, I told you, it is impossible for God to wash away the sins committed by us. The Buddha also cannot do that. The Buddha says like this, Suddhi asuddhi pachyattang nanya manya visode. The purity and impurity, good karma or bad karma, that remains in our mind. Another person cannot change. Another person cannot amend or destroy. That means even Buddha or God or any other living being cannot do this. But the person who has committed that can avoid the bad effect when he understood he had been committing evil, then stop. Not because of fear of God or fear of hell, by knowing that it is wrong. Then from that day onward, cultivate a good karma, life after life, life after life. Bad karma had no chance to come and affect, come and catch. Now let us take Angulimala, you might have heard his name, murderer, who killed 1,000 human beings. The Buddha approached him. The Buddha knew simply by advising he cannot change. There are some people, no one can change their mind by advice. There were two stubborn disciples of the Buddha, very arrogant, very mischievous, very jealous, related to the Buddha also. How many times the Buddha advised you? They did not accept. I remember. By force, another person cannot change the mind. Either God or the Buddha. That person must admit, understand, then he or she can change. Another person cannot change the mind. So what he did? After discussing with the Buddha, he came to know that he had been doing very cruel, very wicked, very dangerous thing. Then decided to stop. After that he asked, can I follow him? The Buddha says, why not? Then he said, can I become a monk? A murderer? The Buddha says, yes. He was ordained as a monk. And from that day onward, he went on meditating, cultivating and developing his mind. Finally, he attained the arahanthood. I think many others cannot understand the meaning of this word arahanta. The higher stage of sainthood. After that, final salvation, nirvana. The bad karma had no chance to catch him. That is the method taught by the Buddha, my dear friend. There is no point of praying to Buddha or God or Bodhisattvas, please forgive me, I have done. Then if they can wash away the sin today, tomorrow again you can start. So, please think use your common sense. Irrespective of religious label, use your common sense. You have thinking mind. You have sense of reasoning. Don't become slaves to any religion or any god or the Buddha. The Buddha has said, you should not accept anything thinking that Buddha is a great man. Therefore we must accept what he said. No. No use. You must try to understand what the Buddha said. No personality cult. Without depending on the Buddha as a person, you should not try to understand, because Buddha said this, therefore we cannot do that. Recently I was invited to give a talk in a Catholic church. Occasionally we invite each other. Yes, very friendly. Yesterday I had a 1 hour discussion with the Catholic bishop and in television program, it appeared next Saturday. So, after my talk, somebody asked this question. You say, the Buddha says like this. We say, Jesus says like this. Who is correct? And I told him, you can forget your Jesus. I can forget the Buddha. Use our common sense. Example. The Buddha says, we should not steal. Jesus says, thou shalt not steal. Do you think without depending on Jesus, without depending on God, that we cannot understand that stealing is bad? Why do we have to depend on them to understand that it is wrong? They are religious teachers. They appear in this world to remind. It is not that they have created all these things. To remind us, because we have forgotten, we have neglected. The Buddhas appear from time to time. And some other religious teachers like Jesus, Muhammad and Krishna also appear from time to time. They remind us. These are the duties, these are the responsibilities, these are the things that you should not do, these are the things that you have to do. They have not created all these things. But there are people, when they use their common sense, they can understand these things are naturally wrong. Let us take free thinkers. They have no God, no heaven, no hell, no rebirth, no karma, no soul, nothing. Very highly intellectuals. Let us take Bertrand Russell in England. Everybody respects him as a very highly intellectual person, but free thinker. Even Albert Einstein had no religion. But when you see what they have said, remarkable. Although they had no religious label, they had wonderful human intelligence to understand what is right, what is wrong. Do you know why we are called manushya? What is the meaning? Is there any meaning of this word, manushya? It is in Pali, Sanskrit, Hindi, Marathi, Gujarati, Vangal and Malay and so many languages. Same meaning, manushya. What is the meaning? If we do not know the meaning of this word, difficult to regard you as manushya. It's a very meaningful word. Mana means mind. Manusya means one who can raise, develop, cultivate that mind up to the maximum level. That living being is called manushya. Please remember. There is no another living being in this universe who can develop the mind up to that extent like a human being. What is happening in this world today? They develop their human mind up to such extent to destroy the whole world within half an hour. Who created this? God or devil? No, human mind. Human mind can develop that cruelty, that wickedness up to such extent when they misuse that intelligence. That is why Albert Einstein said, science without religion is blind. Yes, they were blind. They developed their intelligence up to the maximum level to discover so many things in this world. But they could not understand not to use these things to destroy the world done by the human being. Do you know our uncle George Bush? Yesterday in our television program, somebody asked how to settle this problem, world problem today. I think it's our Uncle Bush, George, and Uncle, what is his name? If these two can practice give and take policy, then all our problems we can settle. But they are so stubborn, and their, what you call, egoism is so strong, they are not ready to do that. Then we cannot settle any problems. This is the danger of the human mind if it is not cultivated properly. Human mind is the most unreliable, unpredictable, most dangerous energy in this universe. The Buddha has said this. Naham bhikkhave anyam eka dhammam pi samanupassami yatayidam bhikkhave chittam. Chittam is mind. Chittam bhikkhave lahu parivattam. By using his enlightenment, he said, I have never seen another dynamic force that works so rapidly other than human mind. Lightning strike and we have no time to look at disappear. Human mind can work thousands times faster than that. This is the nature of the human mind. If they misuse this mind, although people say God will destroy this world, before that our friend will do the job. On the other hand, those who have cultivated, developed, purified the mind, gain the enlightenment. So one day, when the Buddha was going somewhere, he met a Brahmin. I think you know the meaning of Brahmin. Indian priests and gurus and teachers and masters, so everything, Brahmin. He has never seen such serene figure in his life. He approached the Buddha in a straight way, asked, may I know whether you are a god? The Buddha said, no, I am not a god. In that case, any other form of a supernatural living being? No, I am very natural. Alright. If you are an ordinary man, the Buddha says, no. Now confusing in his mind, who this person is? Then straight away he asked, then can you tell me who you are? And Buddha gave the answer. This answer is very important for us to understand who the Buddha is. If anybody asks you, supposing you're Christian or Muslims or Hindu or freethinker, knowing you are Buddhist, come and can you tell me actually who the Buddha is? Then how am I going to introduce? Buddha was born in Sakya family. When he was 29 years, he ran away from his wife. You would know that. Recently we had inter-religious forum, Buddhist, Christian, Hindu, Muslim, Sikh. After my talk, somebody asked one question. I think he is a non-Buddhist. He said, I heard that the Buddha ran away from home even without telling his wife. Is it not cruelty? He asked. Then I told him, do you know? Because of his running away on that day, today, 555 million human beings run after him. If he stayed at home without running away, only his wife and child run after him, nobody else. Now this introduction, self-introduction of the Buddha is very important. Please remember. Very meaningful, no argument. Anybody can appreciate. He said in his own language. What is the language spoken by the Buddha? You are very funny Buddhist. You don't know. You do not know the language spoken by the Buddha. Pali, P-A-L-I, not B-A-L-I. Pali was the language spoken in northern India at that part of the country at that time. There were many other languages. So the Buddha did not use Sanskrit because that was high-class Brahmin's language. The Buddha did not use. He used the language of the man in the street. Everybody used. Pali is the language. In Pali he said like this. Abhinyayam abhinyatam. I understood everything that which exists in this world. How did he do that? You know, he had to cultivate paramitas, 10 paramitas, life after life, went on developing, cultivating up to the maximum level to understand everything that which exists. Panya, one item of 10 paramitas. Therefore he understood everything that which exists. Bhave tabvancha bhavitam. I have practiced all the great qualities, virtues, noble attitude and principles and morals in this world. Life after life went on developing until he attained the final goal. Pahatabbang pahinang me. I have completely eradicated, uprooted all the evil thought, evil deeds, evil action. Completely purified the life and the mind. Now developed wisdom, developed the virtues, purified the mind. After that, he gained enlightenment. We use the word enlightenment because of it. Therefore, I am not a god, not an angel, not ordinary man. I am the Buddha. Buddha is not his name. Buddha means one who gained enlightenment. That person is called Buddha, just like Agung. There is no such person as Agung. When he was appointed for 5 years, people say it's Agung. Just like that. So, now let us come to this subject again. Recently we had an interreligious seminar in Kuching. Buddhist, Christian, Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, 5 religious groups. After our discussion, somebody got up and asked one question. Who created this religion? Whether given by the God or whether created by the man? Believe me, Christian, Muslim, Hindu, Sikh, all these 5 people decided not to answer. Because this is a very, very terrible question. If they say, given by the God, there are many who cannot agree with that. If they say he is created by the human being, and orthodox religious people completely go against him. So all of them kept quiet. then ask me to answer the question. Then I thought, I know these four tried to escape. Why not I also escape? Then I told him, I can answer your question if you can answer my question. What is that? Which come first, whether egg or chicken? So, finish. No argument. Otherwise, there will be a hell of argument, trouble, criticizing, attacking. We must know how to avoid such kind of unnecessary thing which create very bad atmosphere and environment. So,
politics 101.
Krishnamurti, I think many of you know, very highly intellectual Indian who had no particular religion, great thinker. He said, human beings who do not think, they are second-class human beings. Why? I told you, human means one who has a thinking mind. Others have no thinking mind. Other living beings, they have a mind from birth. They can use that mind only to find out their food, their shelter, and their protection, and little bit of pleasure. Besides these things, they do not know how to develop their thinking, nothing. Again, it is mentioned the difference between humans and animals. Do you know what is the difference between humans and animals? Did you think? No. In Sanskrit language, mentioned like this. Ahara nidra bhay maitunancha samanya metat pasubhir narana dharmo hitesan adhiko visesa dharmena hina pasubhir tama. There are four things which are very common to every living being in this universe, whether they are big or small. Eating, sleeping or relaxing, self-protection, and sex. Every creature, whether big or small. Eating, sleeping, protecting their life and experiencing sex. Every living being. So if human beings also spend their life only for this purpose, for purpose, what is the difference between humans and animals? Is there any difference? We can say they have tail, we have no tail. They have four legs, we have only two legs. There is no difference. But there is a difference. Dharmo hitesan adipo visesa. There is something which is called dharma. This dharma we can find in any of their minds. This dharma we develop by thinking, understanding, reasoning, realizing, experiencing, but others do not get this. By thinking they cannot. By force we can tame them. The lions and tigers we can tame by beating and beating. Because of fear, they follow. But not through understanding. No development in their mind. So, what is this dharma? Today we use the word religion. For this ancient word, we use the word religion. What is the meaning of religion? When you see the dictionary, you can see so many meanings. But this is not an English word. This is either Latin or Greek. I am not sure whether Latin or Greek. The original word is religio. What is the meaning? Binding. Religio means binding, that's all. But when this becomes a religious word, as religion, they have given another meaning for that. Binding to God. That word binding to, they add the word God. Binding to God, worshipping, praying to God, so many words later they add. That is written. Binding to God. But dharma, dhar is a Sanskrit word. You know, Sanskrit, Pali, Hindi, all those languages, they have root of the word. From this root, create a word. Dhar is the root of the word. Dhar means whole. Dharma means that which holds us. Dharma. The definition is given. Chatusu apayesu cha vatta dukkhesu cha apatamane tattva dharete iti dhamma. Dharma means the method that we uphold, never allow us to get into hell, animal, a spirit, ghost, devil, or unfortunate living being. Dharma is holding us without allowing to get into this unfortunate state. See how meaningful it is. Again, in the teachings of the Buddha, Dhammo have rakkati dhammachari. One who lives in accordance with the dharma. Dharma is the universal law. This universal law protects us, supports us. If we violate this universal law, this dharma, we have to experience the bad effect. Even without religious label, universal law, take for instance, every living being has living right. It is a universal law. We have no right to destroy their life by violating that universal law. Then we go against the dharma. Then we have to pay the bad effect for that by violating that universal law. All the existing qualities, virtues, principles, duties, responsibilities are belong to this universal law. Of course, many people believe, given by the God, Or some people say given by the Buddha or given by the Bodhisattvas. But when we use our common sense, we can understand according to our experience. For millions of years, our experience. Then finally when development, understanding, develop, then we decided, understood, oh, these things are bad, these things are good, these things are useful, these things are dangerous. Then harmony, unity, cooperation, understanding, patience, tolerance, all those things are not given by another, God or Buddha, our own experience. So, now scientific knowledge is working. That scientific knowledge is very dangerous. We have gone beyond the limit of our normal human intelligence. I told you just now, all the nuclear weapons that they have produced so far, if they have collected and blast at once, the whole world turn into ashes within half an hour. So we are living on time bomb. Not only that, they believe the moon also will be affected. Yes, that energy, moon also will be affected. If man can land on the moon, no, I cannot send this energy into the moon. So this is the problems with the human mind. We have religions. Actually, nobody wants to practice religion, tell you very frankly. They are doing something else in the name of religion. Some people try to show they are religious people by praying 100 times a day. They are religious people because they worship. Some others pray and worship. Some others offerings and offering. Some others burning and joysticks and papers, and they try to show they are religious. My dear friend, where is religion? Religion is in the mind. Religion is not in the temple. Religion is not in the Buddha image. Religion is not in the church or the mosque. We have converted, our mind converted them into places of worship. It is not that building itself become holy. Our mind created. Therefore, religion is in the mind. Then what is the use of our praying and worshipping and offering? If you cannot reduce our anger, jealousy and grudge and ill will and enmity and cruelty and all the wicked things from the mind, what is the use of worshipping? Main purpose of religion is to train the mind. If religion cannot do that, no point of following any religion. We bluff. Religious people, actually they bluff every religion. For their own benefit, collecting more donation. Building huge building, pagodas, images, to collect money. There is no religion. Religion is in the build up our mind. Reduce our jealousy, anger, greed and enmity and cruelty, wickedness. Then everybody can live peacefully. Religion is there. So, today they misuse. Politicians complete politics, I mean they polluted. Religion. For for their benefit, they use the name of politicians. For their material gain, they use religion. It is not that they want to send them to heaven to collect more money. Use name of religion for that. My dear friend, I beg you, I advise you to think what I have said. Try to adjust, change little bit of your thinking and understanding and way of life by realizing these things are bad. We know they are bad. Not because Buddha or Jesus or Muhammad said like this. We know they are bad. And these things are good. We also can understand. We make mistake not because we are stupid. Just because we do not know that it is wrong. Why do we commit bad things secretly? Knowing it is wrong. Otherwise, no reason for us to do secretly. We know it is wrong. Therefore, we have to train the mind. When you observe the precept, five precepts, you recite one word, is a very important word. Panatipata veramani sikkhapada. Sikkhapadam samadhiya. What is the meaning of this? It is not a law. In Buddhism, you cannot find law. You cannot find commandment. You cannot find religious punishment in Buddhism. All these are advices given by the Buddha. He said, if you do this, you have to pay for them. If you do this, you can have a peaceful life. That is his way of life. He has never said, you should not do this, or you must do this. He never used that language. He never said, if you don't follow me, I send you to hell. So, now let us take this word, Sikkhapadam Samadhiya. What does it mean? I try to train my mind not to do when this bad idea appears in my mind. See how meaningful it is. Not as a law given by the God or Buddha or anybody. By knowing it is wrong, I try to train my mind not to do this when that idea appears in the mind. That is why you recite all those five, Panatipata, Adinnadana, Sikkhapada, train the mind. Therefore, main purpose, as I mentioned, the main purpose of all these existing religions is to train, to develop the mind to gain better understanding. Why unnecessary, unhealthy, unethical religious competition among these existing religions? For what purpose? Religion has become nuisance to the public. No peace because of religion. What is the purpose of religion? More than 100 Muslim university students came to our temple last Sunday to learn Buddhism for 2 hours. They are educated, some lecturers. After my talk, I told them, by listening to me, if one of you come and tell me that you want to become a Buddhist, then I ask, what is wrong with your religion? What is wrong with your religion, can you tell me? If you really practice your religion, you are very close to us. Just because you do not practice your religion, you are far away from our religion. So what people are doing in the name of religion? They do not follow the religious principles. Just pray and worship, that's all. Then, religious harmony, unity. If religionists cannot develop harmony and patience and tolerance and understanding, how can they advise others to develop all these qualities? Every religion teaches, love others. But they cannot love another religion. Enemy. Another religion is enemy. Why they cannot love others? Because they believe it is their duty to condemn, to accuse, to blame other religion. This is my religion, therefore I protect them, drag others into my religion, condemn all the other religions. What a pity, what happened to religion? This is the nature of religion. The whole world is a battlefield today because of religion. If they remain without any religious label, I think they can live peacefully. We started at what time? 8, isn't it? Now 9:15. So anything else that you want me to... Thank you very much. I really appreciate your indulgence. Very respectfully, you have listened to what I said. And nobody wanted to challenge. You can challenge if you like. I have no objection, but I don't want to challenge. Anything that you want to know, please.